Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's residency.
Don't bother me, I'm working. Let me, I'm working. Don't bother me. Don't bother me. Can't you see?
BBC Radio 1 Resident.
Radio 1 Resident DJ.
From the underground to the arena.
Let me holla at the DJ.
Tonight on the Residency.
George Fitzgerald on Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
This is George Fitzgerald. Welcome to The Residency on BBC Radio 1. Just easing you in here with a track off my album. This one's called About Time. It's featuring the wonderful Boxed In. You're with me for 2 hours, and after this track we're going to go in the mix for about an hour, and then we're going to be hearing from Alan Fitzpatrick.
Fitzgerald.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
So that was a nice intro. Let's go into the mix now.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's residency with George Fitzgerald.
Dance music on Radio 1.
Radio 1's residency.
We're starting off with something nice and chilled here. This is by Gaucho Lustwerk. Lustwerk. It's finally releasing some bits which actually came out on a mixtape called 100% Gaucho from 2 years ago. And he's finally brought all of them out and they're absolutely stunning. There's another track called I Never Seen and it's on his label Lustwerk. I recommend you check all of them out. This is amazing. This one's called Parley.
Thank you.
Fitzgerald.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Playing at the moment is something new by Bodica and Joy Orbison. It's called Tricky Makes the Tea, after Mr. Tricky. Special shout out to anyone who caught me and Joy Orbison playing back to back at Wildlife and Parklife festivals. It's always a massive pleasure playing with Joy O. I think our styles go pretty well together.
Thank you.
George Fitzgerald.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
You're listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1's Residency. Here with you till midnight, and then John Hopkins will be on after me. The domino takeover as ever. Currently playing in the background just for the last few minutes, this has been Anti-Alias. First I've heard of them, but this is a wicked track. It's called Somber Clarity. They're apparently from Berlin and it's on Shakrap. Just building things up slowly, we've got lots more to come. We've got Alan Fitzpatrick, the South London Techno Don, in the studio soon. And then brand new tracks from people like Mind Again, Terriers, and me, myself, lots more.
Violence. This is
George Fitzgerald,
Radio 1,
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
And me on the remix of Yoris Fawn and Matthew Dipp. Absolutely massive. See this track doing a lot of damage on some terraces this summer. It's the best kind of slow builder, this one. It just goes mad at the end.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Dust, dust, dust,
I gotta admit, I slept on this tune a little bit. It came out about a month ago by a producer called Magit Cocoon. I think that's the way you pronounce it. She's from Tel Aviv but lives in Berlin now. That's called No Compromise and it's on her excellent album. I recommend you go and check that out. So you're listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1's Residency. Going to be taking you through to midnight. There's John Hopkins after me. Be in the mix for about another 20 minutes and then we've got Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio. Going to be telling us what he's been up to recently. We'll be right back. So this one just playing is something brand new by Mind Against and Sumner. Coming out very soon on the prolific Life and Death label. Called Vertere. Listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1. Just playing at the moment is a brand new track by two Irish guys called Terriers. It's called Serpio 800 and it's the B2 on their release for a new label called Rhythm Nation. To be honest though, what's far more interesting about these guys is their backstory, which is they were taken on in some kind of apprenticeship by Levon Vincent that he advertised on his Facebook page. And they went to Berlin and were kind of tutored in whatever way, I don't know what you call it, by the legendary Levon Vincent. This is one of their first releases afterwards. So everyone's quite excited to hear from them. We'll be right back.
Residency with George Fitzgerald.
I've just playing for the last few minutes was another new track by Anne Me. It's called Trilogy. And coming in now, we've got something by Herbert, Matthew Herbert, of his new album. This track's called Peaks, and it's the concluding track on his album, which is called The Shape, which is absolutely amazing. I recommend you go and get it or listen to it.
You
such an amazing way to round out an album. This track's got another 4 minutes to run. I'm not going to play all of it. I'd love to. It's usually 10.5 minutes long. But this is Radio 1, so I'll cut it short. You're listening to George Fitzgerald on the Residency, BBC Radio 1. Just a couple more tracks, then we're going to have Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio. And then lots more new music after that.
George Fitzgerald on Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Track is by Rounds. It's the Atlas remix. A track called Filter. And just coming in now, we've got something brand new from Tough City Kids on the remix, aka Gerd Jansen and Lauer. Prolific remix artist, but it's always good. This one's a remix of Steve Cobby, and the track's called We Start Over. Managed to just be the right side of retro kitsch. Never too cheesy, it's absolutely perfect. It's men with good taste, definitely. Into the second hour now. So I thought I'd slow it down a little bit first before we have Alan Fitzpatrick in and we step it back up again. This is an absolutely superb track. It's by John FM. It's tucked away on the B2 of a release, recent FXHE Records release. It's called Solace 322.
Solace, babe. Please don't promise nothing that you think you can. tell you so. You love me now. Love it when you're so damn unpredictable.
Listening to George Fitzgerald on the BBC Radio 1 Residency, and I'm joined in the studio at the moment by Alan Fitzpatrick. Hey, Alan.
Hey, man. How you doing? You all right?
Yeah, good. Thanks for coming out. It's pretty hot outside.
It is indeed, yeah. My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, but it's not too far for you, is it? You're from South London, right?
I'm from Southampton, actually, yeah. But still not far.
And is your studio down in Southampton as well?
It is, yeah. I've got an outbuilding at the bottom of the garden that I go and escape into, so...
Oh, okay. Yeah, every man needs a shed.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Okay. So, most of the listeners, a lot of the listeners will know who you are. The people who don't will, you know... Mr. Fitzpatrick, I suppose you're known originally for your kind of history with Drum Codes and kind of latterly like a slew of massive remixes and original productions in the last couple of years, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. It's been a busy few years and it's been exciting.
So. Yeah, I mean, how long, I mean, I wouldn't insult you and call you a veteran yet, but you've been around for a while, haven't you?
So. Yeah, I've been writing music for a long time now, a good 10 years or so at least. So.
Definitely a lot longer than me. which is pretty impressive in itself, to be kind of at the top of your game for this long, so, yeah.
Thank you.
We're now kind of... almost label mates, aren't we?
We are,
I suppose.
Yeah.
which is definitely cool. I haven't done, I'm talking about Hot Flush Recordings, which is Scuba's label. And you brought a release out recently, didn't you?
Yes. I was excited to do that release. I mean, I've been a fan of the label for a long time, so
yeah.
When I did that series of tracks, it sort of, I naturally thought that was a good home, so I sent them to Paul and.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the style fits perfectly, doesn't it? It's just kind of, you know, when Paul told me about it, I just thought it was completely logical.
Yeah.
And it's definitely a massive release. But I mean, I suppose recently you've been doing a lot of remix work.
Yes, I have. Yeah. It's been a funny one because the success of the Trust Me remix definitely brung a lot of people knocking on the door.
Which was, I suppose, a lot of people know about it, was basically one of the biggest tracks last summer.
Yeah.
In Ibiza and anywhere.
Yeah.
I pretty much didn't go to a club all of last summer without hearing that.
Yeah, it was crazy because for me it was a slow burner as well. Yeah. I wasn't necessarily playing it loads when I'd done it, and then I think that always happens. Someone else picks up on it and then you know it just sort of blows up. But yeah, off of the back of that there was a lot of remix requests, and fortunately all of the stuff that I was offered was really good stuff, so I couldn't turn a lot of it down. Yeah, it was really, really good stuff.
So. I don't know how you do it though, to be honest. I mean, maybe there's something magic going on in that shed, but like I struggle sometimes to find enough time to do all the remixes, and it's probably because I'm lazy, but it's pretty impressive, you know, one, that you do that, you're doing so many remixes, but two, that they're all good.
Yeah,
you know, because so many people, I mean, let's be honest, so many people churn out bad remixes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
you know, because you don't have the time. So yeah. That is pretty amazing. What's the most recent remix that you've done?
The most recent one I've finished is for Hypercolor.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I just remixed a track by Bearskin and Jay Wilshire.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And recently, before that, was a remix for RG, which is coming on B-Pitch Control.
Cool.
Yeah. They're really good tracks as well. I'm excited for people to hear them. So.
Nice. Well, let's hear one. You've got one that you brought with you, which is a Left Field remix, right?
Yes, yeah. The Left Field remix is also... it was a super huge honour to be able to do that. You know, I've been a fan of Left Field for a very long time. And when they asked me to remix their latest single, obviously jumped at the chance. So it's a bit different from what people might expect from me, but yeah. I wanted to be brave with the mix, you know. So
it's a special one, isn't it? I mean, I'm a little bit jealous that you got to do Left Field, because they're definitely somebody, you know, that I grew up, you know, one of the reasons I got into dance music as well.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
Yeah, why not, you know, go for something extra special.
Yeah, yeah. So, and yeah. I'm very happy of how it turned out. I haven't actually got to play it in any form of live environment yet, so I'm looking forward to dropping that. So.
Cool, well, let's hear that now. This is. Do you want to introduce it?
Sure, yeah. This is my remix for Left Field of their latest single. The track's called Bilocation, the Alan Fitzpatrick remix.
My lips in the storm, just a pattern.
So that was the Alan Fitzpatrick remix of Bilocation by Left Field, and I'm joined by Alan in the studio at the moment. Yeah, so you went for a kind of breakbeat approach on that almost, didn't you? I mean, I can hear the... I mean, do you have a background in sort of old school rave and stuff like that? Or
yeah, that's sort of my sort of basis of what got me into dance music and stuff, really. But especially with approaching that remix, like, you know, sometimes you get parts and you kind of have an idea of where you want to take it, but that vocal was really strong, and I thought doing a kind of 4-4 thing and using all that vocal wouldn't have sounded too great, so I went for that more of a breakbeat approach.
And cool. Yeah, it really comes off. Yeah, it's really nice to, you know, that people were kind of, I suppose in our scene, house and techno, people can be a little bit too attached to the 4-4 beat sometimes, yeah, and they're not brave enough to kind of go off reservation. But that definitely comes off, so congratulations. So the two labels you've mainly been associated with have been like Drum Code and Hot Flush.
Yeah.
How have you found it dealing with Paul? You go on, dish the dirt on him.
No, it's been fun, you know. He pulls a man of few words, which I quite like, you know, and I like that he will speak his mind if he doesn't like something. Yeah, he's cool to deal with, he's good fun.
yeah, definitely a man of few words. It's Paul, by the way, for listeners, is Scuba. A little bit too familiar in the studio at the moment. Yeah, but we should play something off the last release, to be honest, because I thought that was absolutely amazing. That's the last release you did for Hot Flush. So if I could pick something now, let's maybe listen to the A1, which was Falling Down.
Sure.
Wasn't it? Yeah, so this is Falling Down by Alan Fitzpatrick. Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1. I'm joined by Alan Fitzpatrick, and we were just listening to Falling Down, which was on Hot Flush Recordings. You know, just listening to that, you know, I've wanted to ask you, in that shed of yours, do you have some sort of massive rack of hardware, or are you more kind of, you know, this is, I get to ask nerd questions on the show sometimes.
Yeah, sure. Well, this particular track I did down in Portsmouth with Dave Robertson, who's okay. Reset Robot. Yep. But we've got a very similar setup. We both basically got sheds with studios,
yeah.
But we both use the same stuff. We just, everything's done on Reason.
Yeah?
Yeah, so.
Wow. Okay. Well, that shows you, you know, I spent a not inconsiderable amount of money on loads of synths, and I couldn't notice the difference.
I have got hardware stuff that I've spent like a lot of money on, which just gets dusty. Yeah. Some of it's at my studio, some of it's at Dave's, and because we sort of share a lot of stuff where we're quite close proximity to each other. But yeah, I've never used any of it.
Yeah, it just goes to show that it's all. I mean, it's a cheesy thing to say, but I suppose it's all about the ideas, isn't
yeah,
it?
Definitely.
Rather than how, you know, how you're getting inspiration, and I suppose a lot of people find, as you maybe said, hardware kind of gets in the way, having loads of machines and everything, but some people vibe off that.
Certainly when I write a lot on the road, at least sort of on flights doing loops and stuff,
yeah,
it just makes it a lot more easier if when I transfer that into the studio it's all there rather than me having to sort of repatch stuff about. And
cool, we should listen. Actually, it just occurred to me, we had Rasheen Murphy on the last show, and we should listen to your remix of Rasheen Murphy probably. I mean, Did you chat to Rasheen when this came about? Or, you know, sometimes you don't have contact with artists, do you? When you get given the remix, you just do it. But
yeah, we did speak a bit. Basically, again, Rasheen was a fan of the Trust Me remix, and yeah, that's how it came about. And yeah, she'd asked me to do that, the first single. So I was really happy with that, the way that came out as well. It was a really cool remix to do because you've got so many different parts of this kind of disco, jazzy, kind of crazy original. So you can take a lot of elements into that sort of 4/4 environment, and her voice is amazing, so it was really good to work with that.
Yeah, but so when I get remixes by someone and who's a really good singer, and Rasheen is a really, really good singer, it just makes your life a lot easier, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
You don't have to sort of hide how bad they are.
Yeah, there's no auto-tune, or there's no sort
yeah,
of
exactly.
Sitting it behind something else, it's really, really prominent, so.
Cool, so let's listen to that. This is Alan Fitzpatrick's remix of Exploitation by Rasheen Murphy.
just don't know who.
I don't see it as amusement.
Who's exploiting who?
The price isn't right.
I just don't know who. Who's exploiting who?
Was Rasheen Murphy Exploitation, Alan Fitzpatrick's remix. We're still keeping Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio with us. You know, so what's coming up? I've been asking you about like stuff in the past and everything. You know, you said you've got a couple of remixes coming up with Hypercolor and RG, but you know, what's next gigs wise? We're actually playing in Sonar together, aren't we?
We are. I'm looking forward to that. It should be a good one.
Is there anything, you know, I read somewhere that you were thinking about doing a live set or...
Yeah, there is. I've been toying with the idea of it. I mean, I've been sort of playing around with bits and bobs on Ableton. It's quite a daunting thing for me because I'm just only sort of a DJ through and through. So the whole concept is new, but it's kind of exciting. If I have a kind of jam session, it's cool. But we'll see. Yeah, the plan is to maybe do some special shows.
Yeah,
but it's still very much in its infancy at the moment.
Yeah, I've got a similar situation with my album. But putting together, you realise that like playing live is quite scary.
Yeah,
you get very used to DJing, and then live suddenly seems like this very exciting yet completely terrifying thing that people do.
Yeah.
So well, you know, going back to you as a DJ, I mean, what stuff out there at the moment is really exciting you?
There's a lot of stuff I've been playing, but one of my favourite tracks at the moment is a new thing on Ben Clock's label by Trevino. My favourite on the EP is a track called After the Rain.
Cool, so let's listen to that. But before we play that, thanks Adam for coming in.
My pleasure.
And I look forward to the gigs we're doing, and good luck with everything this summer.
Cool, thanks very much, man. You too.
Have Cheers. A good summer.
Radio 1's Residency.
So a massive thank you to Alan Fitzpatrick for coming in there. The guy's a certified rave destroyer. I'm sure you're going to be hearing a lot of those tracks everywhere this summer, just like last summer. You're listening to George Fitzgerald. This is The Residency and we're into the last half hour. And in half an hour's time, you're going to have John Hopkins. It's going to take you through to 1 a.m.
Radio 1's Residency.
Residency with George Fitzgerald.
So that track just playing was by Heartthrob on his own label. Brand new EP in that track is called Does Your Car Know? It's the Melody Mix.
This is George Fitzgerald,
Radio 1,
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Something brand new and fresh by Acid Mondays. It's coming out on RNS and it's a remix of a track called Miz by Lacquer. Big shout out to Dan and Alex, the Acid Mondays boys, my Ibiza housemates.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's residency.
Something brand new and fresh by the mighty D-Tron. It's called The Believer. And this is the dub version. Gave this a spin for the first time at Parklife in the tent with Joy Orbison. Job absolutely kicked off, to be honest. Something of a recent classic here. This is about 6 months old, maybe about 8 months old. It's by DVS1. It's on the Clockworks label and it's called Black Russian. reminded to play this one. I bumped into DVS1 at DC10 about a week or two ago. It's absolutely smashing the place up. He's one of the best DJs I know in any style, house or techno. Whether it's in Berlin or Ibiza or anywhere else, you must check him out. The last 10 minutes of the show. I'm George Fitzgerald and you're listening to The Residency on BBC Radio 1. Coming up very, very shortly, we've got John Hopkins. But just now, as the last dance floor focused tune of the night, this is an exclusive. Deviation 33 by Trick, and it's the Lock Groove remix. Coming out on my label, Man Make Music, very, very shortly. Well, a couple of months. That's a short time for dance music.
Radio 1's Residency.
So you've been listening to The Residency for the last 2 hours. Got one more hour tonight. And then next week, it's going to be Heidi and Solomon in place of me and John. Also to look forward to Detroit Swindle on the Essential Mix. That's massive. But let's finish things off with a track of mine from my recent album. Don't think I've played it on the show yet. It's called Shards.
George Fitzgerald on Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
To the show on iPlayer for the next 30 days. You can also see the tracklist of everything that's been played tonight. I've been George Fitzgerald and I'll see you next month. Hi there, this is George Fitzgerald. Welcome to The Residency on BBC Radio 1. Just easing you in here with a track off my album. This one's called About Time. It's featuring the wonderful Boxed In. With me for 2 hours, and after this track we're gonna go in the mix for about an hour, and then we're gonna be hearing from Alan Fitzpatrick.
This is George Fitzgerald,
Radio 1,
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
So that was a nice intro. Let's go into the mix now.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency with George Fitzgerald.
Dance music on Radio 1.
Radio 1's Residency.
we're starting off with something nice and chilled here. This is by Gaucho Lustwerk. Lustwerk. Finally releasing some bits which actually came out on a mixtape called 100% Gaucho from 2 years ago, and he's finally brought all of them out and they're absolutely stunning. There's another track called I Never Seen and it's on his label Lustwerk. I recommend you check all of them out. This is amazing. This one's called Parley. Playing at the moment is something new by Bodica and Joy Orbison. It's called Tricky Makes the Tea, after Mr. Tricky. Special shout out to anyone who caught me and Joy Orbison playing back to back at Wildlife and Parklife festivals. It's always a massive pleasure playing with Joy O. I think our styles go pretty well together.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency with George Fitzgerald.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
You're listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1's Residency. Here with you till midnight, and then John Hopkins will be on after me. The domino takeover as ever. Currently playing in the background just for the last few minutes, this has been Anti-Alias. First I've heard of them, but this is a wicked track. It's called Somber Clarity. They're apparently from Berlin and it's on Shakrap. Just building things up slowly. We've got lots more to come. We've got Alan Fitzpatrick, the South London Techno Don, in the studio soon. And then brand new tracks from people like Mind Against, Terriers, and me, myself, lots more. George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1. I'm joined by Alan Fitzpatrick, and we were just listening to Falling Down, which was on Hot Flush Recordings. You know, just listening to that, you know, I've wanted to ask you, in that shed of yours, do you have some sort of massive rack of hardware, or are you more kind of, you know, this is, I get to ask nerd questions on the show sometimes.
Yeah, sure. Well, this particular track I did down in Portsmouth with Dave Robertson, who's okay. Reset Robot. Yep. But we've got a very similar setup. We both basically got sheds with studios,
yeah.
But we both use the same stuff. We just, everything's done on Reason.
Yeah?
Yeah, so.
Wow, okay. Well, that shows you, you know, I spent a not inconsiderable amount of money on loads of synths, and I couldn't notice the difference.
I have got hardware stuff that I've spent like a lot of money on, which just gets dusty. Yeah. Some of it's at my studio, some of it's at Dave's, and because we sort of share a lot of stuff where we're quite close proximity to each other. But yeah, I've never used any of it.
Yeah, it just goes to show that it's all, I mean, it's a cheesy thing to say, but I suppose it's all about the ideas, isn't
yeah,
it?
Definitely.
Rather than how, you know, how you're getting inspiration. And I suppose a lot of people find, as you maybe said, hardware kind of gets in the way, having loads of machines and everything, but some people vibe off that.
Certainly when I write a lot on the road, at least sort of on flights doing loops and stuff,
yeah,
it just makes it a lot more easier if when I transfer that into the studio it's all there rather than me having to sort of repatch stuff about. And
cool, we should listen, actually it just occurred to me, we had Rasheen Murphy on the last show, and we should listen to your remix of Rasheen Murphy probably. I mean, Did you chat to Rasheen when this came about? Or, you know, sometimes you don't have contact with artists, do you? When you get given the remix, you just do it. But
yeah, we did speak a bit. Basically, again, Rasheen was a fan of the Trust Me remix, and yeah, that's how it came about. And yeah, she'd asked me to do that, the first single. So I was really happy with that, the way that came out as well. It was a really cool remix to do because you've got so many different parts of this kind of disco, jazzy, kind of crazy original. So you can take a lot of elements into that sort of 4/4 environment, and her voice is amazing, so it was really good to work with that.
Yeah, but so when I get remixes by someone and who's a really good singer, and Rasheen is a really, really good singer, it just makes your life a lot easier, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, definitely.
You don't have to sort of hide how bad they are.
Yeah, there's no auto-tune, or there's no sort
yeah,
of
exactly.
Sitting it behind something else, it's really, really prominent, so.
Cool, so let's listen to that. This is Alan Fitzpatrick's remix of Exploitation by Rasheen Murphy.
And run, you son of a gun. And we can-
exploiting who?
The price isn't right.
I just don't know who, who's exploiting who?
Was Rasheen Murphy Exploitation, Alan Fitzpatrick's remix. We're still keeping Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio with us. You know, so what's coming up? I've been asking you about like stuff in the past and everything. You know, you said you've got a couple of remixes coming up with Hypercolor and RG, but you know, what's next gigs wise? We're actually playing in Sonar together, aren't we?
I'm looking forward to that. It should be a good one.
Is there anything, you know, I read somewhere that you were thinking about doing a live set or...
Yeah, there is. I've been toying with the idea of it. I mean, I've been sort of playing around with bits and bobs on Ableton. It's quite a daunting thing for me because I'm just only sort of a DJ through and through. So the whole concept is new, but it's kind of exciting. If I have a kind of jam session, it's cool. But we'll see. Yeah, the plan is to maybe do some special shows.
Yeah,
but it's still very much in its infancy at the moment.
Yeah, I've got a similar situation with my album. But putting together, you realise that like playing live is quite scary.
Yeah,
you get very used to DJing, and then live suddenly seems like this very exciting yet completely terrifying thing that people do.
Yeah.
So well, you know, going back to you as a DJ, I mean, what stuff out there at the moment is really exciting you?
There's a lot of stuff I've been playing, but one of my favourite tracks at the moment is a new thing on Ben Clock's label by Trevino. My favourite on the EP is a track called After the Rain.
Cool, so let's listen to that. But before we play that, thanks Adam for coming in.
My pleasure.
And I look forward to the gigs we're doing, and good luck with everything this summer.
Cool, thanks very much, man. You too.
Have Cheers. A good summer. So a massive thank you to Alan Fitzpatrick for coming in there. The guy's a certified rave destroyer. I'm sure you're going to be hearing a lot of those tracks everywhere this summer, just like last summer. You're listening to George Fitzgerald. This is The Residency and we're into the last half hour. And in half an hour's time, you're going to have John Hopkins. It's going to take you through to 1 a.m.
Radio 1's Residency.
Residency with George Fitzgerald.
Track just playing was by Heartthrob on his own label. Brand new EP in that track is called Does Your Car Know? It's the Melody Mix.
This is
George Fitzgerald,
Radio 1,
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Something brand new and fresh by Acid Mondays. It's coming out on RNS and it's a remix of a track called Miz by Lacquer. Big shout out to Dan and Alex, the Acid Mondays boys, my Ibiza housemates. Managed to just be the right side of retro kitsch. Never too cheesy, it's absolutely perfect. It's men with good taste, definitely.
Residency.
So we're into the second hour now. So I thought I'd slow it down a little bit first before we have Alan Fitzpatrick in and we step it back up again. This is an absolute superb track. It's by John FM. It's tucked away on the B2 of a release, recent FXHE Records release. It's called Solace 322. George Fitzgerald on the BBC Radio 1 Residency, and I'm joined in the studio at the moment by Alan Fitzpatrick. Hey, Alan.
Hey, man. How you doing? You alright?
Yeah, good. Thanks for coming out. It's pretty hot outside.
It is indeed. Yeah. My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, but it's not too far for you, is it? You're from South London, right?
I'm from Southampton, actually. Yeah, but still not far.
And is your studio down in Southampton as well?
It is. Yeah. I've got an outbuilding at the bottom of the garden that I go and escape into. So.
Okay. Yeah, every man needs a shed.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. So most of the listeners, a lot of the listeners will know who you are. The people who don't will, you know. Mr. Fitzpatrick, I suppose you're known originally for your kind of history with Drum Codes and kind of latterly like a slew of massive remixes and original productions in the last couple of years, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. It's been a busy few years and it's been exciting.
So. Yeah, I mean, how long, I mean, I wouldn't insult you and call you a veteran yet, but you've been around for a while, haven't you?
So. Yeah, I've been writing music for a long time now, a good 10 years or so at least. So.
Definitely a lot longer than me. which is pretty impressive in itself, to be kind of at the top of your game for this long, so, yeah.
Thank you.
We're now kind of almost label mates, aren't we?
We are,
I suppose.
Yeah.
which is definitely cool. I'm talking about Hot Flush Recordings, which is Scuba's label, and you brought a release out recently, didn't you?
Yes. I was excited to do that release. I mean, I've been a fan of the label for a long time, so when I did that series of tracks, it sort of, I naturally thought that was a good home, so I sent them to Paul and
I mean the style fits perfectly, doesn't it? It's just kind of, you know, when Paul told me about it, I just thought it was completely logical.
Yeah.
And it's definitely a massive release. But I mean I suppose recently you've been doing a lot of remix work.
Yes, I have. Yeah, I've just it's been a funny one because the success of the Trust Me remix definitely brung a lot of people knocking on the door,
which was I suppose a lot of people know about it, was basically one of the biggest tracks last summer.
Yeah.
In Ibiza and anywhere.
Yeah.
I pretty much didn't go to a club all of last summer without hearing that.
Yeah, it was crazy because for me it was a slow burner as well. I wasn't necessarily playing it loads when I'd done it, and then I think that always happens. Someone else picks up on it, and then you know, it just sort of blows up. But yeah, off of the back of that, there was a lot of remix requests, and fortunately, all of the stuff that I was offered was really good stuff.
Yeah.
So I couldn't turn a lot of it down. Yeah, it was really, really good stuff.
Yeah.
So.
I don't know how you do it though, to be honest. I mean, maybe there's something magic going on in that shed, but like, I struggle sometimes to find enough time to do all the remixes, and it's probably because I'm lazy. But it's pretty impressive, you know. One, that you do that, you're doing so many remixes, but two, that they're all good.
Yeah.
You know, because so many people, I mean, let's be honest, so many people churn out bad remixes.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
You know, because you don't have the time. So yeah. That is pretty amazing. What's the most recent remix that you've done?
The most recent one I've finished was, or is, for Hypercolour.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I just remixed a track by Bearskin and Jay Wilshire.
Oh, wow, yeah.
And recently before that was a remix for RG, which is coming on B Pitch Control.
Cool.
Yeah, they're really good tracks as well. I'm excited for people to hear them. So.
Nice. Well, let's hear one. You've got one that you brought with you, which is a Left Field remix, right?
Yes, yeah. The Left Field remix is also, it was a super huge honour to be able to do that. You know, I've been a fan of Left Field for a very long time. And when they asked me to remix their latest single, obviously jumped at the chance. So it's a bit different from what people might expect from me, but yeah. I wanted to be brave with the mix, you know. So
this is a special one, isn't it? I mean, I'm a little bit jealous that you got to do Left Field, because they're definitely somebody, you know, that I grew up, you know, one of the reasons I got into dance music as well.
Yeah,
and why not, you know, go for something extra special.
Yeah, yeah. So, and yeah. I'm very happy of how it turned out. I haven't actually got to play it in any form of live environment yet, so I'm looking forward to dropping that. So.
Cool, well, let's hear that now. This is. Do you want to introduce it?
Sure, yeah. This is my remix for Left Field of their latest single. The track's called By Location, the Alan Fitzpatrick remix.
Down the grace of government, lounging around.
So that was the Alan Fitzpatrick remix of Bilocation by Left Field, and I'm joined by Alan in the studio at the moment. Yeah, so you went for a kind of breakbeat approach on that almost, didn't you? I mean, I can hear the... I mean, do you have a background in sort of old school rave and stuff like that? Or
yeah, that's sort of my sort of basis of what got me into dance music and stuff, really. But especially with approaching that remix, like, you know, sometimes you get parts and you kind of have an idea of where you want to take it, but that vocal was really strong and I thought doing a kind of 4-4 thing and using all that vocal wouldn't have sounded too great, so I went for that more of a breakbeat approach. And
cool, yeah, it really comes off. Yeah, it's really nice to, you know, that people were kind of, I suppose in our scene, house and techno, people can be a little bit too attached to the 4-4 beat sometimes, yeah. And they're not brave enough to kind of go off reservation, but that definitely comes off, so congratulations. So the two labels you've mainly been associated with have been like Drum Code and Hot Flush.
Yeah.
How have you found it dealing with Paul? You go on, dish the dirt on him.
No, it's been fun, you know, he pulls a man of few words, which I quite like, you know, and I like that he will speak his mind if he doesn't like something. Yeah, he's cool to deal with, he's good fun.
yeah, definitely a man of few words. It's Paul, by the way, for listeners, is Scuba. A little bit too familiar in the studio at the moment. Yeah, but we should play something off the last release, to be honest, because I thought that was absolutely amazing. That's the last release you did for Hot Flush. So if I could pick something now, let's maybe listen to the A1, which was Falling Down.
Sure.
Wasn't it? Yeah, so this is Falling Down by Alan Fitzpatrick.
Thank you. dreams of the night. We have a gift of care. We have a moment of silence. We have this time to give to you. A future of no violence.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
And me on the remix of Joris Ford and Matthew Dipp. Absolutely massive. See this track doing a lot of damage on some terraces this summer. It's the best kind of slow builder, this one. It just goes mad at the end.
Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
I slept on this tune a little bit. It came out about a month ago by a producer called Magit Cocoon. I think that's the way you pronounce it. She's from Tel Aviv but lives in Berlin now. That's called No Compromise and it's on her excellent album. I recommend you go and check that out. So you're listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1's Residency. Going to be taking you through to midnight. It's John Hopkins after me. Be in the mix for about another 20 minutes, and then we've got Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio. Going to be telling us what he's been up to recently. So this one just playing is something brand new by Mind Against and Somna. Coming out very soon on the prolific Life and Death label. Called Vertere. We'll be right back. You're listening to George Fitzgerald on BBC Radio 1. Just playing at the moment is a brand new track by two Irish guys called Terriers. It's called Serpio 800 and it's the B2 on their release for a new label called Rhythm Nation. To be honest though, what's far more interesting about these guys is their backstory, which is they were taken on in some kind of apprenticeship by Levon Vincent that he advertised on his Facebook page, and they went to Berlin and were kind of tutored in whatever way, I don't know what you call it, by the legendary Levon Vincent. This is one of their first releases afterwards, so everyone's quite excited to hear from them.
Yeah.
So that just playing for the last few minutes was another new track by Anne Me. It's called Trilogy. And coming in now, we've got something by Herbert, Matthew Herbert, of his new album. This track's called Peaks, and it's the concluding track on his album, which is called The Shape, which is absolutely amazing. I recommend you go and get it or listen to it. such an amazing way to round out an album. This track's got another 4 minutes to run. I'm not going to play all of it. I'd love to. It's usually 10.5 minutes long. But this is Radio 1, so I'll cut it short. You're listening to George Fitzgerald on the Residency, BBC Radio 1. Just a couple more tracks, then we're going to have Alan Fitzpatrick in the studio. And then lots more new music after that.
George Fitzgerald on Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1's Residency.
Beautiful track is by Rounds. It's the Atlas remix. A track called Filter. And just coming in now, we've got something brand new from Tough City Kids on the remix, aka Gerd Jansen and Lauer. Prolific remix artist, but it's always, always good. This one's a remix of Steve Cobby, and the track's called We Start Over.
Thank you.